Do you want glass skin? How can we get the perfect glass skin? Do you want to have impeccable skin even when your skin is zoomed in? Hey guys, welcome back to Wishtrend TV. It's your sister Eunice here. Really happy to see you guys. Woo, time flies. Summer is almost over and autumn is right around the corner. And I feel like during the daytime, it's getting hot still, but at night, it's a bit chilly. That's why I think my skin is a bit dry because of the change in the weather. And if you also feel like your skin is becoming dull or dry after your skincare routine, it may be a sign that you need to exfoliate. Today, we have a very special series ready for you guys. We're so excited to share. We're gonna be sharing everything you need to know about exfoliation in three episodes. The first one is going to be about chemical exfoliation, second one is going to be about physical exfoliation, the third one is going to be about body exfoliating tips, so please stay tuned in. Now before we get started, don't forget to follow us on our Instagram at Wishtrend TV and subscribe to Wishtrend TV and like this video. Let's get started. Why do we get buildup of dead skin cells? Naturally, as we age, our skin's turnover cycle changes. When you're a baby, it takes about 14 days. When you're in your teens, it takes about 21 to 28 days. When you're in your 20s to 40s, it takes about 28 days to 42 days. And when you're in your 50s and above, it can take up to 42 days to even 84 days. During this skin's turnover cycle, the epidermis layers, all the dead skin cells there is completely peeled off. And then the new skin layer underneath the dermis layer becomes the new outer layer. But oftentimes, not all of the dead skin cells are completely peeled off. That's why you get buildup of dead skin cells, dull skin, and clogging of pores as well. Now, when this happens, you need to exfoliate your skin to keep your skin healthy. And when should you exfoliate? It's a great question. We have a checklist right here that you can ask yourself. The first question you should ask is, does my skin look more dull than before? And do you see more fine lines even after moisturizing? And does your skin feel more dehydrated than before? And does your skin tone look uneven? And are you getting more breakouts than before? All of these can be a symptom that you need exfoliation. Mainly, there are two different types of exfoliation. First, you have chemical exfoliation, and then you have physical exfoliation. Now, to put it really simply, chemical exfoliation is using a chemical substance to remove dead skin cells. Physical exfoliation is using physical force to remove dead skin cells. Today, we are going to talk about chemical exfoliation. Let's talk about the different types of chemical exfoliating ingredients. The first one is AHA. Alpha hydroxy acid is also known as AHA. It is a plant-based chemical substance that is extracted from fruits, and it is water soluble, and it actually exfoliates the outer layer of your skin, and it contains glycolic acid, citric acid, malic acid, and lactic acid, and it is very hydrating to your skin, and also it helps with collagen regeneration. However, there is a con. It can make your skin sensitive to the UV rays, so whenever you use a product with AHA, you do have to wear sunscreen. Now let's move on to the second ingredient, which is PHA. For PHA, you have gluconolactone and lactobionic. Now PHA is very similar to AHA, but it does have a larger molecule size, so it sinks down into the skin slower, which makes it less irritating to the skin. And also, it doesn't make your skin sensitive to the UV rays like AHA does. Now let's go with BHA. Unlike AHA that works to exfoliate the outer layer of your skin, BHA is oil soluble. It will sink deep into your pores to cleanse out pores and to remove dead skin cells, and it will also help with inflammation. Also, BHA includes salicylic acid. All right, so let's go with LHA. LHA is extracted from salicylic acid, which is a BHA ingredient. And like BHA, it is oil soluble, so it will sink deeper into pores, but it's less irritating to the skin because of its high liposolubility. So the chemical reactions actually hit slower, which makes it less irritating for the skin. The fourth one is enzymes, and enzymes are mainly extracted from fruits. And unlike AHA, BHA, PHA, or LHA, it doesn't affect the skin's turnover cycle and naturally exfoliates your skin. And it cuts the links that holds the dead skin cells together and makes the dead skin cells fall out. However, it doesn't push out the new skin layer like other chemical exfoliating ingredients. Now, there are so many different types of chemical exfoliating ingredients. Let's find out which one will suit your skin type the best. Now, for dry skin types, we want to recommend AHA. AHA is really hydrating because it is water-soluble. Also, it exfoliates the outermost layer, which is perfect for dry skin types that need to secrete out more sebum. And please don't forget to hydrate your skin right after exfoliation. Now, for dry and sensitive skin type, we want to recommend low percentage of AHA, around maybe 5%, because higher the percentage means stronger exfoliating effect, or we want to recommend PHA, which is very similar to AHA, but has a larger molecular size, so it sinks down to the skin slowly, which is less irritating for the skin. And for dry skin types, we want to recommend that you exfoliate about once every week or 2 weeks. Now, if you have oily, acne-prone skin, we want to recommend that you avoid physical exfoliations, because most likely, if you have acne-prone skin, you're going to have a lot of inflammation, and you want to avoid any ingredients that can cause more inflammation. So we want to highly recommend that you use a chemical exfoliating ingredient. And we want to recommend BHAs. It is oil-soluble, so it will help to remove the dead skin cells and sebum that can clog your pores. And also, it does help with acne scar recovery. If you have acne-prone sensitive skin, we want to recommend you try LHA because it sinks down into your skin slowly. All right, for acne-prone skin types, we want to recommend that you exfoliate about once a week. Now, if you feel like most exfoliators irritate your skin, such as physical exfoliators, AHAs, BHAs, PHAs, or LHAs, we want to recommend that you use an exfoliator with enzymes. It doesn't peel off the epidermis layer, but it melts the impurities and dead skin cells on the surface layer only. And it is the safest option for you if you have sensitive skin. And for sensitive skin types, we want to recommend that you exfoliate your skin about once every week or 2 weeks. Sadly, most aged skin is sensitive and dry. However, you can't skip exfoliation just because your skin is dry and sensitive. Exfoliation is amazing for skin regeneration, and also it will help the active ingredients to soak better into your skin. Now, if you want to prevent moisture loss during exfoliation, we want to recommend that you use AHAs. If AHA seems a little bit too strong for you, then try using PHAs. And if PHA is still irritating for your skin, then try enzymes. But the most important thing is to hydrate your skin thoroughly after exfoliation. And also for aged skin, we want to recommend that you exfoliate about once a week or 2 weeks. That will be enough. Now, you can't just stop here. Of course, exfoliation is important to keep your skin healthy. However, aftercare is as important. So we have three tips right here ready for you for aftercare. The first one is, don't forget to moisturize your skin after exfoliation. Repetitive exfoliation without proper moisturizing care can make your skin even more dry. Exfoliating not only gets rid of dead skin cells, but it removes the oil that is very necessary to protect our skin. So we want to recommend that you use ingredients like glycerin. Glycerin is such an amazing ingredient that holds the moisture underneath your skin. The second tip is apply sunscreen before you go out. Now, this is a really important tip because your skin is more prone to the UV rays after exfoliation. You want to make sure you wear sunscreen because it can easily damage your skin. Remember, if you don't wear sunscreen, it can make your skin age faster. And don't forget to choose a sunscreen that can hydrate your skin. The last tip is to give your skin a break after exfoliation. You want to make sure to avoid any exfoliating ingredients after exfoliation if your skin has not recovered yet completely. We want to recommend that you use soothing ingredients such as Centella Asiatica or Guajulene. Today, we talked about the different kinds of exfoliating chemical ingredients. Now, for the tips and skin types that we didn't mention today, no worries, because we're going to mention that in our next episode. Stay tuned in for that. And don't forget to follow us on our Instagram at WishtrendTV and subscribe to WishtrendTV and like this video, and we will see you next time. Bye, Wishtrenders!